things, messages, the room, webinar. Okay. Good evening, everyone. It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is my Wednesday night webinar. Starts at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on every Monday and Wednesday night, starting at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I've got a radio show from 9 to 11. That's 9 to 11 a.m. on AM 790, Talking Business. And that's in the Rhode Island market, but it's heard around the world. And you can also get me on Meerkat. What's up, guys? As well as you can get me live online through my website. What I need you to do, the reason why I do these Monday and Wednesday and Saturday webinars and radio shows, excuse me, I'm getting over something here. The reason why I do them is because every day I get about 12 to 20 questions a day, Facebook, Twitter, email, phone call, all looking for free help. I love giving out free help, but I don't have the time to do it. So I do it at night during these webinars. I want you to know that no matter how badly behaved your dog is, number one, we work with your dog. There's no way your dog is worse behaved than the dogs that come into my center. So I work with, you know, young puppies, but I specialize in aggression rehabilitation. Okay. So I specialize in aggression rehabilitation. So all these dogs that you've got at the house, we can probably most likely easily rehabilitate. And the way you're going to do that is by watching all my do-it-yourself videos on YouTube, by asking me questions, attending my Facebook page on a daily basis. I just put up one video today. I've got another one I'm going to be putting up tonight. I've got another YouTube video that I'm editing. Simple, simple stuff. If you train your dog just a couple of commands, you will get the dog you want. It is not that difficult. Absolutely not that difficult. I want people to know that training is consistent. It never ends. But that doesn't mean you're going to make your dog a robot, or you have to treat your dog like a robot. You can still have a family dog that listens to you. So it's really, really important. So now it's time for people that are on my webinar to put in your chat box, put in your questions, and I want you to put them in to admin only and make them private. And for everybody on Meerkat, put in your questions, all right? So put in your questions. And thanks, everybody on Meerkat. You guys have been great supporters. Really, really appreciate it. Okay. Sharon says, hi, Jeff. My dog Shiloh is afraid of storms and fireworks. Today is Canada Day. Yep, I heard that. Happy Canada Day. I'll actually be up in Canada in the end of September for a seminar, as well as the beginning of October for a seminar. Go to rvdogtrainer.com, rvdogtrainer.com. And I've got two seminars coming up in Canada. Should I put her in the crate or just let her pace? Absolutely don't let her pace. Do not let the dog pace. What I want you to do is this. First of all, it's too late to do any training. Like, that's over with. You're in the middle of it now. So you now is not the time to prepare for battle. You're in the middle of battle. So what I want you to do is leash on, collar on. Can you get her to stop pacing? Can you put her in a down? If you put her in the crate, what will your dog do? Will your dog relax, or will your dog do circles? What I want you to do is I want you to interrupt the pacing, interrupt the anxiety. That's what you've got to do. So in the future, what I want you to do is train your dog to have a rock solid down, a rock solid place. And I want you to start playing fireworks, not tonight, when Canada Day is over. We've got our July 4th. So our July 4th is Saturday, but we've got a lot of fireworks going on in our neighborhood. During mealtime and during the course of the day, I want you to start playing thunder and fireworks. Download the sound effects on YouTube. And what we do is we've got a sound effect track. Put it right on your phone, start it at a low level, and play it during your dog's meals. Start out low. Gunshots, fireworks, thunderstorms, lightning. Play those sound effects at a low level, slowly increasing the level. The dog will start reassociating that with something scary as that with something good. It takes time. What a lot of my hunt trainers do and what a lot of my service dog people do, and my, all of our police dogs, and all the horses, all the police horses, is there's a CD you can buy of all the street sounds, of every street sound out there. And imagine a police horse or any type of horse in public, what you've got to do, you've got to be able to acclimate these dogs and these horses to these sounds. So you start out low level, you increase, and you do a combination of duration work as well as commands. Duration work as well as commands. All right, try that out. But you also probably want to go to my seminars. Very inexpensive seminar I'm doing up in Canada. There's two of them. I'm doing one up by in Montreal area, and then one over them in West Montrose, which is west of Toronto. All right. You can see the states. That's great. So yeah, you'll probably get a double whammy. I love Canada. I love it up in Canada. I go up there a lot when I'm not turned away from the border. I've been turned away from the border in Canada two times. Two times I was turned away. So what are you going to do, right? You guys are strict up there. You're strict. But now I sat down with a border guard, an ex-border guard, and I asked the border guard all the important questions about how not to get turned away next time. So I won't get turned away anymore. Linda says for her, she says she can use Valerian root, V-A-L-E-R-I-A-N. Valerian root now, ? I don't know. She uses it for her fosters who are new and there's no time to train. So try that. Thanks, Linda. That was great. Carol. Carol says, last night my 22-pound dog was attacked by a dog bolting out of the house. That sucks. Will this have a negative effect on the progress I've made with decreasing leash reactivity? Absolutely. Absolutely. If it doesn't, I'd be surprised. So hopefully it won't be, but let's pretend it's going to be. All right? What's the best way to protect your dog? Best way to protect your dog is this. You carry bear spray. You carry a hiking stick. Okay, you carry mace, and Linda says it's herbal. It's herbal, so it works. Awesome. Thanks, Linda. You're walking your dog. So what I want you to do is this. You use your foot. You use anything possible to protect your dog. So you're walking your dog in an off-leash dog. What you don't do is pick up your dog because you're going to end up getting bit. And what I want you to do next time, and we teach this, and it's happened to me many times. If I'm walking my dog or dogs, I've got 9. If I'm with my children, if I'm with my spouse, I'm old school. All right. I'm old school. You got to get through me to get to them. So what I do is I neutralize the threat. I consider an off-leash dog coming at me. I consider a person coming at me a threat. I'm a very, very nonviolent person. I use words to neutralize people all the time. Well, I really don't have to anymore because like people don't, like, why would you be a threat to me? But a dog, I neutralize usually with physical force. My dogs go behind me. I stand in front of my dogs. I tell the dog to stop in a very firm voice. I move my body forward. If that doesn't work, I wait till the dog is close enough and I kick that dog as hard as I can. I kick that dog in the head or I kick that dog right in the rib cage. And I will continue to do so till that dog leaves. Now, some people might struggle with that, which makes me wonder, why? Why would you struggle with that? Well, maybe the dog wanted to come over and play. How did I know that? My dogs have been attacked numerous times. They've been attacked with a human present, and that human says, my dog is friendly, and then the dog attacks mine. So I don't believe you. If your off-leash dog comes at me, I will neutralize your dog. Number one, I probably saved your dog's life. Because if your dog gets to my dogs, I assure you, it will not be good. My dogs don't start fights, but my dogs are absolutely allowed to protect themselves, and they absolutely will. One of them will. A bunch of them, it won't be good. So number one, it pisses me off that my dogs had to practice that behavior. I don't want them to. I want them to go through life not having to practice that behavior. I want them to know that I could protect them. I take this very seriously. It's a major problem. You can also carry a stun stick. We have stun sticks. I show stun sticks. We have them in our training center. Carry a hiking stick. Carry bear spray. Carry mace. Okay? Do anything. Do not pick up your dog and try to run. Okay? Keep your dog on the ground and use your feet. Okay. I hope that answered your question, Carol. Okay. Meerkat, can you off-leash train a dog using Marco asked me, can you off-leash train a dog using vibration or do you need the e-collar with the stim mode? Good question. You can off-leash train your dog with no remote collar, but I don't train on vibrate. Do you live in a country where you're not allowed to use, so Marco, answer this. Do you live in a country that you're not allowed to use the remote collar, but you're allowed to use the vibration collar? Is that why you're asking the question? Because I know I've got some clients that live in countries that they're only allowed to use the vibration. If you do, absolutely, absolutely. Now, I'll give you a little helpful hint though. What a lot of my clients are doing, the problem with vibration is you can't increase it or decrease it. But what a lot of my clients are doing in the countries that are using, that either don't allow the dog to have a collar, because I train dogs in Germany, and I train dogs in parts of Canada and UK that are not allowed to the collar. What you can do is you can train the dog at the privacy of your own home with a regular remote, with stim, and you use the vibration right before you use the stim. So vibration becomes the stim. So vibration has a huge meaning to it. Yep, e-collars are banned in Quebec. I got it. Yep. Okay, got it. So what I would do is you can also put a bandana on your dog, Marco. You can put a bandana on your dog. But yes, you can. Answer your question, yes, you can. So what I'd like you to do, by the way, I'll be up in Canada. I'll be close to Quebec. I've got a seminar that I'm going to be doing. I don't remember what city it is. But if you go to rvdogtrainer.com, you can go and I'll actually teach you how to do it. But what I want you to do is use the vibrate and then proceed it with stim. But do that somewhere private where no one's going to see you, obviously, because it's against the law. And then vibrate is the precursor to stim. So the dog will treat vibrate as well. But you can do it with vibrate only. Absolutely. Absolutely. Dog's on a long line. The way we train recall, you use vibrate and you use food. We train dogs on food with food all the time. Now, there is a company called Big Leash They do have adjustable vibrate. So you can look into that. You can also hide the remote. A lot of my clients are hiding the remotes with a bandana. So you can try that as well. All right. Thanks for tuning in from Canada, by the way. Thanks. Okay. Bonjour. That's all I know. Sorry, I know. I'm an American. Okay. I don't say that proudly sometimes. I know. I say it proud. I love my country. But the fact that I didn't learn more than one language, well, it's my fault. I could have taken a second language. I didn't do well in school at all. You know. Hi, Jeff. I heard you mention not being able to find experienced trainers. Rehabilitation of aggressive dogs is my hobby. Yes, I know, a strange hobby. I'm considering opening my own training school, but would consider relocating to work for you. I would love to discuss this with you. Megan, absolutely. What I want you to do is two things. Number one, you can intern with me, and I would help you open up your own school. So if you want to intern with me and you say, Jeff, I do not want to work with you. I want to intern with you for 3 months. And when I leave, I want to be able to have the business skills and the skills to open up my own training school. You can. Also, you can go to my seminar series, Train the Trainers with Sean and Jeff, www.trainthetrainerswithSeanandJeff. Either way, you probably should go to that seminar because there's a big difference between being able to train and rehabilitate a dog and being able to create a business out of it. I know a lot of really good dog trainers, extremely experienced dog trainers who are failing at business because they don't have the business sense. They don't have the social media, the business sense, the customer relation sense. A lot of times they're really bad with people. A lot of people that are good with dogs are bad with people. It's a people business. That's who pays us. That's who we have to train. So, but either way, what I want you to do, is you email me jeff@solidcaninetraining.com. And I'm going to broadcast Diana. Diana's, hey, Diana, man, I'm madly in love with you, honey. Kiss, kiss. Okay. I'm proud of you. I emailed you back, by the way. The dog, Diana, that you emailed me about, take it, board and train, all your safety protocols, start with the basics. All right? You'll do it. You'll do it. So, Megan, I'd be more than happy to talk to you. More than happy to talk to you. All right? Okay. Meerkat, I love you guys. Thank you so much. If you like this, like it. If you want to retweet it, retweet it. Okay. Let's see here. Let's see. What do you do with a mother dog and her puppies? I don't really work with mother dogs and puppies. So that would be, what would I do? I don't know. I would raise them, I guess. So that's not my business. My business is not raising litters, but that's Gabrielle. Gabrielle, what I would do is, depending on how old the puppies are, depending on what week they are, but what I would do is I would not adopt them out until they're 10 to 12 weeks old, and I would probably 10 weeks old, and by the time I adopted them out, they would all be crate trained, and they can go through the night in separate crates. It's 6 weeks old or 7 weeks old. I would start putting them in crates at night by themselves. Then during the day, I'd put them together. But at night, I want them to be by themselves so they don't have separation anxiety. So then when they went to the owners would have a dog that doesn't struggle with separation anxiety. With young puppies, I would put them through tons of confidence building drills. I'd start working with the puppies right from the beginning, using all their food, all food stuff. As soon as they were on solid food, I would start training them. So I don't know. I don't have a lot of experience. Puppies I have experience with, but a mother dog and her puppies. How old are they? You got to give me some more information. I have a foster dog with fear aggression that nips on the butt. We've had her for a while. Can't adopt her out until she, what? Okay. It stopped. So I think you're limited to 140 characters. So Sparks, New Jersey, help me out there. Gabrielle says, how do you get her to go for a walk? You get her to go for a walk just like any other dog. But a mother dog with young puppies, I can care less if she goes for a walk. So a mother dog, with young puppies, what I do is you depends how young they are. You go out to the bathroom, you come in, and you hang out with the puppies. Go out to the bathroom, you come in, you hang out with the puppies. Most mother dogs want to go with puppies. I'm in no rush to take a dog. I can get a dog to walk in 30 seconds. So I'm in no rush to get a mother dog out with their puppies. But I need, you know, what's the end goal, Gabrielle? Tell me what your end goal is. Give me the big picture. Give me the big picture, okay? Give me the big picture. You don't want to have the dog that nips. If you got a dog that nips, don't allow the dog to nip. You've got to correct the dog that nips. So if you've got a nipping dog, it's twofold, okay? Train the dog on all the... So on my... this is all my Meerkat folks, guys. You know, Meerkat, I love you guys. Webinar Jam, of course I know you're here. I'm madly in love with you guys. I got you. What I want you to do is this. Train the dog on all my basic commands. Go to my website, solidcaninetraining.com. Go to my YouTube videos. Do it yourself section. There's a whole section. Train the dog on every single thing, all right? Everything. All the basic commands. So dog should be in a down, dog should be in place, can't be nipping. So let me give you a good example. Only the Meerkat people are gonna be able to see this because I can turn the camera around. Angelo, say hello. So I got two dogs right there. There are two dogs in my 9-dog pack and I got Angelo. Okay, so for instance, If that was the dog, I don't expect your dog to be doing that. But if your dog was lying down and someone walked by and your dog got up, your dog broke command, then you correct it. How do you correct it? For biting, you correct it hard. Non-negotiable. Most of what I do, 90% of what I do is positive. Corrections are positive in my world. It's gentle, it's loving, it's advocating. You nip, you get corrected. End of story. Why? I can't adopt out a nipping dog and we can't own a nipping dog, right? So you correct it. How do you correct it? A leash pop, remote collar. Okay, but I need more information on that. Sparks, New Jersey, why are they completely relaxed? Yeah, they're completely relaxed. Of course they are. All my dogs do calm on command, meaning do this and don't do anything. They're not tired. All my dogs do that. All my dogs in board and train do that. So there's a video that I put up, Meerkat, madly in love with you guys. Thanks for, God, you guys are going nuts with me tonight. Thank you so much. You're like this show, retweet this show, favorite this show, madly in love with you guys. Thank you so much. There's a dog that came into my board and train 3 days ago. There's a video of him up on Facebook. What's the dog's name?
The Golden?
No, the white dog, the pit, Nigel. Nigel, dog aggressive, clamps on a dog's necks, doesn't let go. Watch the video on Facebook. 3 days, you'll be amazed. Okay. Okie doke, let's go back to Webinar Jam. Let me catch up with you guys. Let's see. Hold on, I didn't forget about you guys. Let me get over here. Okay. Lainey, hey honey, how are you? Take your advice on withholding food until she would allow me to put her prong collar on, one morsel at a time. Took 2 days of constant food work, but she comes out of her kennel, looks up at me, and lays down on command and allows me to put the prong collar and e-collar on. Thank you so much. Huh? See, this is what I like. This is what I like. I love this stuff. You took my advice, you did it, and it works. Think about that. You can watch a webinar, you get free advice, you implement it, and it works. I love this stuff. Lainey, I'm so proud of you. Angelo, Auntie D says hi. You want to come over here and say hi to Auntie D? Okay. Later, the end of the show, Diana. good, proud of you. Okay, here we go. Karen, forgive my ignorance, lots to learn. Hey. Ask me about how to fix a car, Karen. I got no idea. Karen, what do you do for a living? I probably got no idea what you do, nor do I know how to do it. Don't worry about it. That's why I do this show. Okay. I'm not the dog trainer that calls you stupid. I'm not the dog trainer that makes fun of you. Okay. Forgive my ignorance. Lots to learn. Watch the video you posted today of the white pit practicing duration, not reacting to person, dog walking in. If I want to practice this, is it okay to move the placemat bed to wherever you're working? For example, if working in the office and working on the computer. No, this is what I want you to do, Karen. I want you to do this. If your dog is on place and you're just starting out, what I want you to do is have the dog on place. I want you to have the dog on a collar, on a leash, have the leash going all the way to you and be stepping on it. Okay? The dog gets off of place. Remember, no at the beginning. For the first 3 days, it's no, just bring the dog back. No, place, bring back. No, place, bring back. Day three of doing the same thing, you keep breaking place. You got to be kidding me. What are you doing here? How many days? What, do you want to stay in kindergarten the rest of your life? This is what I want you to do. We use prong collars. We use remote collars. If you don't like them, wrong show, guys. Okay? And if you've never seen, okay, another thing about prong collars and remote collars, everybody's got this thing. Oh, my God, they're mean. They're abusive. You're using punishment. Da-da-da. Hey, guys, guess what? You're full of shit. Okay? You've never seen me or my staff or my colleagues, meaning people that I recommend and train with, use the tools. All lawyers are not the same. All police officers are not the same. All blacks, Jews, and Hispanics are not the same. All dog trainers are not the same. So get over it. Get over it really quick. 5 million dogs a year are dying, and your dog is out of control. So what I want you to do after day three, you keep breaking place, give me a break. I want you out of kindergarten. I want you to graduate high school. So it'll be no leash pop. Oh, you startled the dog. You didn't hurt the dog. Place. Now the dog goes, ooh, consequence. I understand. Okay. Now the dog's starting to learn. Yes, you can move the bed to different spots in the house. You can move the bed anywhere you want. You can also have different placemats anywhere you want. Okay. Okay. I'm getting to everybody tonight. I'm staying online as long as it takes. Good question, by the way. Good question. Okay. Let me go to Meerkat. Let me go to Meerkat, guys. Hold on. I love you. The good dog, Sean O'Shea. You look so sexy on Meerkat. Oh, Sean. 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 I look sexy all the time, buddy. Not just a Meerkat. Come on. Look at this, huh? Look at this. Let's see. Gabrielle says she starts jumping when you try and touch them. She nips. Well, you got to desensitize your dog to touch. Desensitize your dog to touch. First of all, if you've got a dog that nips at people, you don't let people touch them. Got it? Right off the bat, you can't touch my dog. I don't let people touch my dogs, and they don't nip. Why would I let somebody touch my dog? Let's think about this. Why? Because they like to. I don't care what you like. It's my dog. What do I care if you like touching my dog? It's my dog. You want to touch a dog? Get your own dog. You can't touch my dog. I don't want you touching my dog. Why? I want my dog to be focused on me. I want my dog to only care about me. That's it. Because why? You never know when my dog's going to need to listen to me. I don't want my dog to be excited about you. I only want my dog to be excited about me. Okay? Good. Meerkat, I love you guys. If you like this, like it, favorite it, retweet it, keep asking questions. If you're not familiar with who I am and what I do, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Jay, I can curse today because I'm doing a live show, but thanks for the reminder. I got a live show. So I do a Monday and Wednesday night webinar, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I do it on Meerkat. I do it on Webinar Jam. The link to Webinar Jam, which you can ask questions to as well, is on my Facebook page. All right. And then on Meerkat, I put the link up usually during the day, or just you can just sign right on and my stream comes on. Every Saturday from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, I do a live call and radio show. There's a company called Solid Canine Training. It's my company. We're a working dog kennel. We deal with the most aggressive dogs in the country. We also deal with young puppies. So, you know, we work with the dogs. We work with tons of dogs. We get real results. Okay. Don says, hi, Jeff. I have a possible board and train that is on Prozac. We like to get dog, talk to the vet about getting him off Prozac. Okay. I like to work with dogs off Prozac. I'm absolutely not against medication for dogs, but I like to get dogs off of drugs before I work with them. Because I think most behaviorists, don't actually work with dogs. And I say this out of lots of experience. Now, this is a United States thing. Out of the United States, they call a lot of dog trainers behaviorists. But in the United States, to be a behaviorist, you have to have a medical degree. So an animal behaviorist is different. Then they've got veterinarian behaviorists. To me, that's the biggest joke in the world. I don't say that without, yeah, you know what? I say it with disrespect. Because you guys are doing a disservice to animal owners, dog owners. This is how it works. You ready for this? I guarantee you this is how it works. I'm going to take my dog up to a behaviorist. Okay, great. Okay. I'm going to write down what they do, and I'm going to put it in a sealed envelope, and I'm going to give it to you. Don't open up that sealed envelope until you're done with the behaviorist, right? If it doesn't match, I'll give you $100. If it does match, you come to me. I'll show you how to really train your dog. So this is what happens. You go there with your dog. You tell the behaviorists your opinion, your uneducated dog owning opinion. Okay? They print out a 100-page form. Most likely, they'll tell you your dog is aggressive. And they'll give you a prescription for Prozac, and they'll charge you $500. They'll never touch the leash. They'll never work your dog. Never. Not once have I seen it happen. I'm up by Tufts University. They should call that Prozac Nation. They should call it Prozac Nation. It's bullshit, okay? It's ridiculous. It's a joke. Work the dog. So when do I recommend medication? A dog does a three-week boarding train. They're off drugs. I work them through my system, and I work them hard, and I work them good. I might say, you know what? Let's see. Let's talk about a little bit of medication maybe. So if your dog used to be on 40 milligrams, 60 milligrams, maybe we're down to 10. Okay. Let's see. Hold on here. Do you think medication, this is a meerkat. Do you think medication would ever be necessary in a case of separation anxiety? Depends what your definition of separation anxiety is. What I want you to do. Watch my video on separation anxiety on YouTube. Okay. Another thing, keep in mind, I'm a working dog trainer. Okay. You can't ask me a question usually, unless it's like about vet stuff, because I'm not a vet. Okay. Don't ever take medical advice from a dog trainer. Don't ever take legal or accounting advice from a dog trainer or nutritional advice. All right. Watch my video on separation anxiety. It's on my YouTube channel. Now, listen to this. You ready for this? Working dog kennel. Right now, I got 20 dogs in my kennel. More than half on their intake forms. Massive, severe, a little bit. Okay? Separation anxiety. Guess what? You ready for this? 24 hours. Not a peep out of anybody. No signs of anxiety. No signs of stress. What am I, magic? What are we, drugging them? No, they're off drugs. But guess what? They're calm. Why are they calm? Structure, guidance, training, rules, exercise, boundaries. And you know what they don't get at the beginning? They get no love and affection. None. Zero. You think that's mean? I wish, you're welcome, Don. I wish love and affection could fix a dog. I would open up Jeff's Love and Affection Dog Emporium. Would you imagine that? I would love it. I would love it. Bring your dog in. Come on. Get it over here. Come on. Get over here, puppy. Let me give you a little hug. Right? You're cured. Oh, what do you got? You got aggression issues? Come here. What? You bite people in the face? Oh, let me give you a kiss on the face. You won't bite anymore. It's a freaking snake oil salesman. That's what it is. It's bullshit. Okay, here. How do you get a dog to stop chasing cats? Don't let the dog do it. There's a crittering protocol you can do. There's a crittering protocol you can do, but you can also teach the dog the word no. You can make it very uncomfortable for the dog to chase cats. But there's a crittering protocol. I got a colleague named Sean O'Shea from The Good Dog, thegooddog.net. He's got a video on crittering. Look him up. If he doesn't, tell him to make one. All right? He'll make it before me. He loves to make videos. He loves them. Okay, he loves them. You can do a crittering protocol. You can also have a consequence high that does it. Marco, I love your video on separation anxiety. It's for a client of mine who also went to a vet behaviorist who gave meds. See, am I right or am I right? I know. And you're in Canada. See, they're all the same, aren't they? Doesn't make a difference what side of the border. It's a North American thing, right? It's crazy. Do they do that in Mexico? In Mexico, they do it too? Everybody here, a meerkat, you can see. Oops. Say hello to everybody.
Hello, guys.
You can speak in Spanish if you want to.
Hola. Español. ¿Alguien habla español?
She's here from Mexico. Okay? She's from Mexico. And I'll give everybody on webinar jam. Go ahead.
Hello, guys. How are you?
Okay, that's it. All right, let me get back to my questions. Okay, hold on. Here we go. Karen, where do I get one of those beds? You go to petcot.com. Petcot.com. Tell them Jeff sent you. Solid canine training. And guess what? You get 10% off. Okay? Karen, took possession of an owner surrender, golden retriever, end of January, went into heat within a week and experienced such psycho crazy behavior towards my other dogs. I got six daughters. What the hell do you think was going to happen? Finally got her spayed, 90% improvement. We still go after my other dogs or fosters if they get too close to her when she has a toy. You got to teach your dog how not to do that. I don't know if there was a question in there though. So you got to teach your dog how to be around other dogs. Hold on here. There's too many questions. Hold on. Okay. Hold on. We got a lot of questions. Hold on. Nancy, your questions are being split up. I want to make sure I get them. All your questions. Diana, good. You took the client. Good for you, honey. I'm proud of you. Diana says, I love you. I love you too, Diana. Okay. Nancy, you got all these questions here unless we got 25 Nancys. Let me see if I can get this right. I have three dogs, one 7 months old. Any two dogs together in the house is fine, but three is a disaster. I had the remote on. Hold on. I'm getting bounced around. It's like a stock market tip kit. I had the remote on the puppy, but he just blew off 25 when he normally responds to 10. Okay. Number one, Nancy, it all depends on what you were trying to do. And guess what? Dog goes in drive, the numbers don't matter. Okay. If your dog knows a command, don't look at the numbers. Look at the dog, keep dialing up, okay? If your dog, it's a known command, your dog is blowing off, don't look at the numbers, don't be like this, okay? Be like this. Look at the dog. Always look at the dog. Should I set it 30 and make sure that it's tight enough and try again? Number one, it should always be tight enough. And also, I'm not gonna tell you what number to set it at. You know why? The dog's gonna tell you the number. Don't listen to me when it comes to the number. Listen to the dog. Karen, you're welcome. She was asked about the pet cut. Okay, hold on here, guys. I start my day at 5 in the morning. Hold on. I got this. This is my wife, Linda, makes this stuff. Apple cider vinegar, honey, and water. I've been taking this. It's great. I love it. Oh, look at this. She'll be pissed off if I show this picture. Huh? I love women with shaved heads. Look at this. Look at this photo. That's Linda. It's the woman I've been married to for a long time. We've been together, what, 15 years now? Okay, hold on. Let me see. Do I believe in crates? Absolutely believe in crates. I make all my clients, crates are mandatory. Crates are, Gabrielle, have you not listened to me before? Come on now. Crates, of course. Crates are mandatory. Hi, Jeff. Joe here. Do you consider your radio show hashtag what would Jeff do to be sacrilege? Thanks. What's that mean? Joe, my producer on the radio show? WWJD? What does that mean? Sacrilege? I don't understand the question. I love crates. Margie says, good to see you on Meerkat. I love being on Meerkat. Meerkat, I love you guys. Guys, you've been great to me. You're tweeting it. You're liking it. You are retweeting it. You're doing great. You're doing a great job, guys. I love it. I love the family of it. I love how much you're promoting the show. You're doing a great job. I'm still trying to figure out how to do training sessions on Meerkat at a regular time. Okay, here we go. I got to go back to Webinar Jam before these guys get pissed off at me. Okay. Claire, and I'm going to get to everybody today. Don't worry. Claire, hi, Jeff. I took my dog to a major busy tourist area today, up and down busy sidewalks like George Jefferson, like you said in one video, past tons of people, smells other dogs. She went head to head with a horse pulling a carriage and did fantastic. Claire, I'm so proud of you. I've been following your directions, first using the prong collar, then the e-collar, doing all your recommendations. That's incredible. It's incredible. That's incredible. It's incredible. Proud of you. Gabrielle, what is this? 20? Are you writing a story? Do I believe in Cesar Millan? I believe there's a person named Cesar Millan. Yes, I know Cesar Millan. So do I believe in everything he does? Of course not. And I don't expect to believe in everything I do. But do I believe in structure, guidance, exercise? Boundaries? Of course I do. Of course I do. But if you're trying to set me up for a stereotype, if you're trying to set me up to say that all I believe is punishing and correcting dogs, I've heard it before. You're going up the wrong tree. You're barking up the wrong tree. Okay. I don't know what you're trying to do. So you're asking me one question. Do I believe in crates? And do I believe in Cesar Millan? Those are the two questions you ask me. All right? So yes to both. Do I believe in Cesar Millan? He's a human being. I know him. I've met him. Am I a fan of him? I like a lot of what he does. I don't believe in what one person does 100% except for myself, or else I wouldn't do it. And I don't expect everybody to believe everything I say. But I've got a working kennel. I've worked with 3,000 dogs. I work with the most aggressive dogs in the country. Dogs fly to me from around the country as well as Canada. And I've got over 1,000 videos and I show my work. I do very transparent dog trainer. So if you don't know enough about me, I would suggest going to my videos and watch my videos. Go to my YouTube channel. Watch my video, my YouTube channel. Look at my testimonials and ask the people whose lives we've changed. What would Jeff do? May mean, what would Jesus do? It does mean, what would Jesus do? It does. In fact, I'm pretty sure. I'm Jewish, number one. I was raised Jewish. I'm not a practicing Jew, but I was raised Jewish. But I'm pretty sure when the Bible was written, I'm pretty sure. I'm not going to talk. This is not a religious show. It's not a political show. And I don't talk science and dog training. But I'm pretty sure the WWJD was not a big thing back then. So, but what would Jeff do is the name of the show. WWJD is the name of the show. So some people, I guess, might be offended by it. I don't know. I would think they wouldn't be. I mean, it's a radio show about dogs. Okay. Here we go. Ann. Hi, Jeff. Started my current boarding train on e-collar today, day 4 of 2 weeks. She has some seriously bad behaviors that I plan on correcting with e-collar, but I didn't want to jump the gun. How long should I wait to start correcting for jumping on furniture, biting the leash? Okay. Jumping on furniture is right away. And that could be just with a leash pop. That's it. That could just be with a leash pop. You can do, Ann, first of all, kudos to you for doing some boarding trains. All you can do just a leash, do a leash pop. Just do a leash pop. That's it. No. Boom. Counter surfing. No. Boom. All right. Megan, two questions. What is your cat proofing protocol? How do you overcome tear in a dog over getting on the treadmill? Getting on the treadmill, we train dogs. Sometimes they start out deathly afraid. They start out deathly afraid. And we get them on. I've only had one dog that took me more than 10 minutes. 15 minutes tops. We've had dogs that have put on the brakes, not wanting to get on the treadmill. We get them on the treadmill and they walk in 15 minutes or less. Every dog on my property gets on the treadmill. So you're going to have to use a little bit of pressure. What's pressure? Call it force, leash pressure. So we use leashes to get the dog on. So I've got a bunch of YouTube videos on how to teach a dog how to get onto a remote collar. If the dog is deathly afraid, to get on the couch. I mean, I'm sorry, I'm reading my next meerkat question. Deathly afraid to get the dog on the treadmill. This is what I want you to do. Feed him on the treadmill, place on the treadmill, down on the treadmill, down next to the treadmill with the treadmill running. Okay. Get him on the treadmill, bring him off. Get him on the treadmill, bring him off. Get him on the treadmill, sit him on the treadmill. Reward with food, bring him off. Okay? As far as cat-proofing protocols, there's a quittering protocol that you can do. You can go to my colleague Sean O'Shea at thegooddog.net. Sean O'Shea at thegooddog.net. You can go check out his quittering protocol. I would do quittering. It's all done with remote collars. It doesn't have to be done with remote collars, but it can be. And then you can also have a consequence. You can also have a pretty high consequence. All right. Let's see. You're welcome, Joe. Fake or swell on meerkat. What are your thoughts about allowing dogs on a couch? We allow the dog on one couch, but not on any of the others in the house. Okay. All depends on what the dog's behavior is. Aggression, never. Human aggression, dog aggression, never on the couch, never in the bed. End of story, no discussion. It's not open to discussion. For me, that's me. Talk to another trainer, they don't care as much. But my show, my opinion. I allow my dogs on the couch that's in my office. So I'm in my office at home right now. I got a couch, it's a dog couch. But they're not aggressive. But I don't want them on my furniture. Why? Because my dogs are dirty. That's why. Because they run around in the dirt. They run around in the grass. They run around. They go swimming 3 times a day. They stink. You know, they're dogs. You know, they're dogs. They're outside a lot. It's because they're, you know, I don't want to sit next. I don't want smelly dogs on my couch. I got big German shepherds. I got a couple of Chihuahuas. They can be on the couch with me. All my dogs are big dogs. So no dogs. Megan said, thanks, Jeff. I love this interactive forum. Megan, if it wasn't for people like you, I couldn't do this. If I didn't have people on this, this is what the show would look like. Okay. I love it. I love Megan. I love you. I love you. Ann says, thank you, Jeff. Good night. Good night. Karen, I'm interested in hearing more about using the treadmill. We'll look up videos on your site. I take it. This helps exercise during New England winters. Okay. Great points, Karen. Couple of things. This winter, for 3 weeks, we couldn't walk dogs outside. It was a major safety hazard to my staff and the dogs. Our two-lane roads turned into one-lane roads with zero sidewalks. Okay, major, 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 major. So it's not just good for bad weather, rainy weather, cold weather, snowy weather, late nights. It's also good for mental exercise. It is an incredibly tiring, mentally tiring protocol for dogs. Okay. Maybe I'll do a meerkat video on how to get a dog to want a treadmill. Maybe I'll do that. Maybe I'll announce that. There's got to be a dog at the training center that hasn't been on the treadmill. I'll announce something. We have new dogs that came in that probably have not been on the treadmill yet. I'll talk to Shayla. Meerkat, love you guys. Marcos, when you use a correction on a knee collar, do you ever use the shock? If so, when? Absolutely. Well, we don't like to call it a shock because it's not shocking. Shocking is electricity. So Marcos, I got really, really descriptive videos on my website. So the remote collars we use from e-collar technology goes from 0 to 100. Every dog responds to a different level. Now, most high-level remote corrections are for behavior modification. Big difference. So let's separate out obedience from behavior mod. Most dog trainers absolutely do not do behavior modification. They don't know how to do it. They don't want to do it. They don't have the skills to do it. And they just don't know what they're doing. Okay. They don't understand the concept of behavior modification. Okay. Most dog trainers do obedience. So what is obedience? Walking on a leash, sitting, downing, place, and recall. So For behavior modification, we use higher levels immediately. Jumping on a counter, immediate. Jumping on a human, immediate. Fence fighting, immediate. Getting into the trash, immediate. When we rehabilitate dog aggressive dogs, we're not talking about what looks like aggression. We rehabilitate killer dogs. Okay, I'm not being cocky here. We're one of the few people that actually will work with a dog killer. So I challenge a lot of people that don't work with dog killers to show me how to work with a dog killer without using an aversive. It can't be done. In fact, I've got a challenge out there, a $25,000 challenge, that if you can show me how to rehabilitate an aggressive dog without using an aversive, I'll give you $25,000. And it's not a joke. It's for real. We both put $25,000 in escrow, and you prove it to me. It can't be done. It's impossible. You cannot rehabilitate an aggressive dog without using an aversive. If you say you can, you're full of shit. You're an actual liar. You're being unethical. You're lying to the public, and it can't be done. Show me the video. It can't be done. It's impossible. You have to show me step by step by step how you did it, or I've got to be there in person. Okay? It can't be done. It's impossible. But 90% of the work we do with aggressive dogs, positive. Okay? So we use corrections on depending on what the dog is doing. Okay. Karen, first time tuning in. Thanks for answering my questions tonight. We're setting Bear for board and train in a few weeks. So grateful to have found you and feeling so positive. Oh, Karen. Listen to me, Karen. Listen. I hope Lauren called you tonight. Karen, listen. The issue that you described, first of all, Karen, your dog won't be doing that incident that happened today with the door because it's in the crate. The dog won't be doing that issue because we're training the dog. And you will have a ton of training as well. And just to let you know, when you and I do the training, I'm not like this. I'm calm. Okay? This is a show I've got to be entertaining. It's got to be up. It's got to be down. If I sat here like this and I just said, what I'd like you to do is I'd like you to tell the dog to sit and then say good and then give the dog a treat. It can't be like that. That's not me anyway. So when we do the actual training, I'm not like this. So Karen, so I want you to know that Karen's the dog, the owner of the dog that we talked about as we were leaving the training center today, about the dog that jumped up on the door when the delivery person came in. About that. So I know your concerns. You have to remember that you've got to remember that the way your dog is, we can change that. It's called training. Okay? So don't worry about it. Okay. Andrea. Hi, Jeff. I was at the seminar in Gainesville. My German Shepherd has improved a lot with the anxiousness. It has improved, but it's still struggling a little bit. What else can I do to help him? Tell me what the other issues are. All right? So tell me what the issues are. Give me a good example. Lanes. Queenie has obliterated every blanket I put in her kennel. I would like to teach her not to chew the bedding. Is this possible? Or I'm just trying to baby her too much. Okay. You're ready for this. You destroy the blanket. On Monday, on Tuesday, no blanket. On Wednesday, no blanket. Your dog doesn't get blankets in the kennel anymore. It's simple. And if anybody that has a problem with that, do me a favor. Call up a vet. Ask them what it costs to remove a blanket or pieces of blanket from a dog. $3,500 to $5,000. Ask them how many dogs have died by eating blankets. Okay? So, no blanket. Can we fix it? Absolutely. But for now, no blanket. Okay? How dare your dog destroy property of yours? Okay. Jeff, I thought I had a working level with my 18-month-old staff using the mini educator level 5 when I went out to public for a quick structured walk, knowing that I will need to dial up for distractions. I went up and down to find a level that will keep him engaged, and I ended up at level 15. Good. Guess what, Jay? 15's the number. Right? 15 is the number. I'm starting to think I need to get back to layering the remote with a prong because of the distraction level. Is that normal to have a different level? Absolutely. Absolutely. Jay, you're on top. There's absolutely no way that your inside levels and your outside levels are going to be the same. No way. Jay, it sounds like you're doing it right. Lainey? She doesn't have one and hasn't for a while, but it's so freaking hard on the floor of the kennel. Oh, come on. Come on. No, it's not. They're dogs. They sleep on the ground. Okay? They're dogs. They sleep on the ground. Andrea, I know I answered your question. Tell me what else you're trying. Andrea, I'll read it again. Hi, Jeff. I was at the seminar in Gainesville. My German Shepherd has improved a lot with the anxiousness. It has improved, but it's still struggling a little. What else can I do? Tell me what else is going on. What else is going on? Okay, what else is going on? There's a lot you can do, but tell me what you're struggling with. Meerkat, if you like what you're hearing, like it, tweet it, retweet it, favorite it. Okay? Okay. Jay, you're welcome. Awesome, thank you. Marco, this is what I want you to do. I want you to watch some of my videos on remote collar training, some of the basic videos. We do pressure on, pressure off. Remember, Marco, remember, this is how we do the remote collar, okay? We get the working level on the dog, okay? So put the dog into a sit, put the collar on the dog. I want the collar here, or I want the collar here. Nice and snug so it shouldn't move around. Start at zero, hit the button twice, tap, tap. Go to one, go to two, go to three, go to four, go to five. The working level is the lowest level the dog feels. How does the dog feel it? Well, if I put the collar on you, and yes, people, I've put it on myself and I've turned it all the way up. So all the people that want to be like, how would you like it if we put it on you? Shut up. How would you like it if you put the collar on a dog, on your kids? What are you, stupid? Why would I put a remote collar on my children? Your dogs are not your kids. Why would I have my kids eat out of a bowl on the floor? I don't. They eat out of a plate at the table. My children sleep in a bed. My dogs sleep in a kennel. Thermostat, I take my dog's temperature. I stick a thermometer up its ass. My kids, I use that little machine to go like this. They're dogs. Don't give me this. They're fur babies. Good luck. Hold on. Okay. So what I want you to do then, I'm talking too much. I've been talking since 5 o'clock in the morning. So what I want you to do then is you're going to get the working level of the dog. The dog will go, or ear twitch, or like this, okay? Should be under 20. Pressure on, pressure off. Watch my video on come, sit, break. Come, sit, break. Watch my video on the place command. The place command is a great video to watch. Watch this. Watch the video on Gunner. The video I just put out on YouTube on Gunner. Watch that video. You will understand remote collar training. I explain it very transparently. Watch that video and then I'll talk to you on Saturday, okay? It's Lainey. Lene. First of all, Lene, I love your profile picture. I'm not hitting on you. Unless you want me to hit on you, I'll hit on you. But I'm not hitting on you. You're babying her. You're not quite babying her. But I don't want your dog to die. I don't want your dog to die. So we got clients that dogs eat, they eat stuff and then they gotta go to the emergency room or they do die. All right. It's 9:59. Sharon. Okay. That one caught my attention. How do you stop a dog from eating a blanket? Mine simply outgrew the practice, but I'm incredibly curious. Okay, Sharon. Anytime you want to stop a behavior, okay, you make it uncomfortable. Bottom line, anytime you want to stop a behavior permanently, you make it uncomfortable. Got it? Remote collar. Eat a blanket, correction. You keep eating, higher correction. Keep eating, higher correction. So the dog goes, whoa, eating that blanket was very uncomfortable. But with a known blanket eater, we're talking about full ingestion. I would never leave a blanket in a kennel. Absolutely not. You're sleeping on the ground. End of story. End of story. Linda, thank you, Jeff, for all you do. Great show. Linda, thank you. Linda, if this is Linda that I know in rescue, you're doing an incredible job. Gabrielle, sorry, Jeff, I was just wondering, big fan. No, it's okay. It's okay. This is the thing. This is this thing sometimes. I've been doing this for so long. Okay? I've been doing this for so long. I get death threats. I get hate mail. I get surprise raids from the ASPCA. I look at them like, what are you, nuts? Okay? I've had the news media come down on me. It seemed a little passive aggressive. That's all. So I apologize. Okay? I apologize. I made a mistake with you. And I'm being sincere. Okay? I'm being sincere. I apologize. Okay? I apologize. Linda says, thanks. It is. Oh, Linda, you are doing a kick-ass job. Woo! My God. Your job is way harder than me. Oh, my gosh. Jeez. Way, way harder than what I do. She's in rescue. Mm. Oh, my gosh. You got to see the work. You got to see the work that this woman does. I mean, we're talking. Oh, you Autumn, the feral dog mm-hmm. by the swimming pool?
Yeah.
That's I got that dog from through Linda. Jeez, that dog is incredible. Incredible. Sharon, thanks, Jeff. You teach me so much and make me laugh at the same time. You're awesome. Thank you. Thank you. That's the whole idea, right? I think we learn when we laugh, right? All right? I think we learn when we laugh, don't we? I think so. I do. I think we remember things, don't we?
Yeah, we do.
Don't we?
Yeah, we do.
And I think, what rescue is Linda in? Linda, if you want your rescue mentioned, just type it to me and then I'll mention it, okay? If you're still on the air. Daily Bob, I've got some human wisdom from what you said. I'm hooked. Good, thanks. I like Daily Bob, thank you. I'd like to, you know, I mix it up a little bit, right? I mix it up. I got to. This is the thing. My radio show's been on the air for 6 years. Okay, it's been on the air for 6 years. It's heard around the world. It's on every Saturday from 9 to 11. And then I've been doing Meerkat for just about 3 weeks now. And I've been doing my webinars for about a year. And I'm doing about 6 hours of free content. And Linda, her rescue is Mom's Rescue. Put the website up. Linda, put your website up, and I'll retype it so everybody can see it. Okay. And this is the thing. This is the way it works. What do you think about Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training? You bet. You got two options. I love him or I hate him. That's it. There's no in between. Well, I don't know. What do you mean you don't know? How could you not have an opinion on me, right?
Yeah.
You know? How could you not have an opinion on me? I can't tell you how many people can't stand me. That's okay. I can't tell you how many people love me. Good. But please have an opinion. Come on. Okay, I'm going to put thank you. www.themomsrescue.org. Boom. Thank you, Linda. I can also broadcast it. Duh. Okay. Okay, hold on. Hold on. I'm just going through all my questions here. Let's see. Okay, we got this. We got this. We got this. I'm just going through here. Christina says, your methods work. Gemma is the dog I dream she could be, thanks to solid canine training, and I get it following your videos with leash and food training. Good. I also attended your two-day training. Good for you. Good. RVDogTrainer.com. I travel the country. Oh, listen to this, guys. You ready? Big news. Big, big news. You ready for this? RV Dog Trainer. Just go to RVDogTrainer.com. I travel the country doing seminars. We're announcing two seminars this week. Virginia Beach, Virginia, and Maui, Hawaii. Maui, Hawaii. I'm not driving the RV over there, obviously. I'm flying. We're doing a seminar in Maui, Hawaii in October. I'm going to be announcing it with all the details. Okay? RV dog training seminar, two-day seminar in Maui. How hot is that? Huh? Bam. That's big. That one I'm impressed with.
I'm going to fly with you.
That I'm impressed with. If anybody wants to be my seminar girlfriend, you let me know. I'll fly you out there. Okay? And don't worry, my wife doesn't care. She can care less. She cares about me, but she's like, Jeff, this is what my wife says. Jeff, do what you want. You're 49 years old. You got 7 kids. Nobody wants you but me. I love her. I love her. She's great. She's great. She's great. Okay. Thank you, Christina. I'm proud of you. Number one, I'm proud of you. Christina, I'm proud of you for the work you did. See, this is the thing. I do these seminars. They're 2 days, but you're the ones that are doing the work at home. Okay. And Diana, I don't know if I can bring you to that seminar because you and I have got a professional relationship, okay? You know, we can't cross those lines, so you might not be, it might not work with us. It might, but I don't know. You do such a kick-ass job at those seminars. Taya, I've been working with a shelter dog. The problem is I'm having you're having a hard time calming him down before letting him out of the kennel. Do you have any advice how to calm him down in the crazy environment? Absolutely. Okay. This is what you're going to do. I got videos on that too. I got tons of videos. Claire, seminar anywhere in Atlanta? Yeah, Virginia Beach. Claire, isn't, how far away is Atlanta from Virginia Beach? So I'm doing one in, okay, this is what I'm doing. I've got one in, I got one in Virginia Beach, and I got one down in south of Tampa, Florida. Now listen, you want me to do one in Atlanta? I could do one in Atlanta, maybe in January or February, okay? You got to find a place. Email me. Go to my website and email me. It's possible. You want to host it. You're welcome, Christina. Christina says, thank you. You're welcome. Guys, we're going over 10 o'clock. That's okay. So, Claire, I'd love to. But how about those other places, Claire? Aren't they close to you? Megan, I'll be your seminar girlfriend and will be platonic because I'm married and I come with aggressive dogs. Megan, that's not what I'm looking for. Come on now. Come on. And Megan, contact me on either coming to our seminars or everything. Coming to Chicago or St. Louis. Actually, I'll be in St. Louis in September for a seminar. I'm going to the IACP, the International Association of Canine Professionals. It's in St. Louis. And then I'm going to be up in West Montrose, Canada. I'm probably passing through. Yeah, I might pass through Chicago. You want to host, Megan? If you want to host, I'm always looking for hosts. Nicole, we have a 9-month-old Bichon poodle that is having a hard time doing focus training. He isn't terribly food motivated. And we've tried your focus training with his kibble, and he usually just looks down if he's looking at the food. Thanks so much. Okay. Nicole, you want your dog to be food motivated? Guess what? You don't feed it till it looks at you. Got it? So you don't feed your dog till it looks at you. Take your dog's kibble. Do the focus. I got a video on this. Do the focus work. The great thing about what I talk about is I got videos on everything. I got 1,000 videos. So people can think I'm full of it. Good. I don't mind. You might think I'm cocky. The radio show, these webinars are definitely cocky. Absolutely. They're egotistical. They're cocky. This is not who I am when I'm on the training floor. If you ever saw me training dogs, I don't even talk. I actually don't talk to dogs. You'll rarely see me talk verbally to a dog. I'm quiet, I'm balanced, I'm centered. Okay, this is a show. It's a radio show. The content is real, but there's entertainment value to it. Okay, and Meerkat, according to you, you like me. So thanks. Keep tweeting, liking it, retweeting it. If you don't like me, there's got to be a million other shows on Meerkat. Okay, we'll do maybe Hawaii. Is Diana in Omaha? Yes. So Diana is in Omaha. I have a friend. So Diana, do me a favor. Put your website up. Put your website up, and I'll broadcast it. Okay, hon. Nicole. So that's what I want you to do. You don't feed your dog till it looks at you. I assure you, your dog will be food driven. Andrea, not sure if you're getting my question. Haha. Sorry. I went to the seminar in Gaines with my German Shepherd. Anxious has improved greatly, but I have been working on the homework. I've been taken to a dog park and working him outside, but when I get about 20 feet close, he throws a fit and becomes, oh, okay, I get it. Okay. So what you're going to have to do is, number one, I want you to do food focus work, remote focus work. You're going to attach food and the remote. So the remote is going to get you the dog to look at you and to deliver the food. Remote, focus, food. And then you're going to do quittering. So what I want you to do is I want you to get to 30 feet with your dog, walk away, okay? 25 feet with your dog, walk away. 22, walk away. 20, walk away. You're done. Done for the day. Next day, try to get to 19. Try to get to 18. Try to get to 17. On day number 4, stick to 25. Yeah, you go from 17 to 25. Boom, you're done, okay? So every day, don't try to get closer. Every once in a while, but that's it. Diana, put your website up so I can broadcast it. Somebody needs help in Omaha, okay? And what are you doing stepping out on my webinars? How dare you? I know, you had to get another glass of wine. Am I right? Nicole, thanks, Jeff, you're welcome. Megan, do the seminars have to be at a training facility or just a large dog-friendly building? Large dog-friendly building will work. Okay. Megan, email me and I'll email you the information. All right. We're almost done. Angelo, turn that off. It's time to go to bed, honey. Say goodbye to your friends. Say bye-bye and come over here. You have to come over here and say goodbye to everybody on Meerkat and say goodbye to everybody on webinar. Okay. Come on. He's really obedient. I better be obedient. Come on, buddy. Here, give that to me so you don't fall. Put it right there.
Want me to help you?
Yeah. So come over here and say goodbye. Here. So you go to doggone it. I gotta know. I don't know how it's spelled though. Doggone it. And here we go. There we go. I just broadcasted Diana's email address. Come here, hon. Come here. Going to bed now?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's time to go to bed?
Yeah.
Yeah. You want to say, hey, Meerkat?
Hi, Meerkat.
Say, I love you, Meerkat.
Okay.
I love.
Love.
You.
You.
Meerkat.
Meerkat.
Good. Say, Auntie D, say hi, Auntie D. Say hi, Auntie D. Come on. Auntie D's looking at you. Yes, she is. So Diana's is Dog on It Training and Rehabilitation. So you can also email her at there. Your website's not done? You got to be kidding me. You were working on that when you were home with me. Come on. Meerkat, if you like this, if you like the show, tweet it, retweet it, like it. Madly in love with you guys. I'm Meerkat. Good. I'm going to do some training videos. I'll do some live stream training videos. I got to figure out how to do it, though. I mean, I know how to do the technology part. I just got to figure out how to do the process. That's for my Canadian friends, process. Right, Marco? Process. Okay. I'm going to head out. Let me just make sure I said good night. Claire says good night. Diana, I can't believe your website's not done. Shame on you. Shame on you. Angelo, he's kid number 7. How old are you?
7.
How old are you? You're 2. You're 2. And if you go to my Facebook page, if you go to my Instagram page, you'll see a bunch of photos with him with a bunch of dogs. Okay? A bunch of dogs, right? He works with dog, big, huge dogs every day. He works with German Shepherds. He works with pit bulls. He works with Kangals. Karen says, you know what? Say Karen. Say hi, Karen. No. No. Karen says, Angelo, such a sweetie. Sweet dreams, kiddo. Diana says, night, Angelo. Love you. You know, Auntie D. You remember Auntie D, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Lene says, I'm obsessed with your show, both webinar, meerkat up in case one goes down. I feel empowered when training Queenie and my family can see it. Thanks for all of it. Hey, thank you. Thank you. Megan says, hi, Angelo.
Hi.
Hi, Megan.
Hi, Megan.
Yes. All right, guys. Madly in love with you. Madly in love with you. I'll see you guys Saturday, 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. You can get me on Webinar Jam. You can actually call into my show. Oh, here we go. 888. 345-0790. 888-345-0790. Call in, talk to me, ask me your dog training questions, all right? Whatever you got, I can handle. Facebook, it's a great way. Every day you'll see anywhere from 6 to 8 posts on Facebook. You see a little bit of you have videos. You got training videos. Go to my YouTube channel. Of course, I'm going to promote myself. That's what this is. It's all about promotion, right? Okay. You're welcome, guys. When I say I'm madly in love with you, I mean it from my heart. I appreciate you so much. I'm proud of everybody that's working with their dogs. We don't need to be killing our dogs. There's no place for a badly behaved dog except for in your home, but trained and rehabilitated. It is not that difficult to do. It's not that difficult to do. All right? All right, guys. Take care.